Hello everyone, this is C.S. Divesh Goel, practicing company secretary in Delhi. Today in this video, we are going to discuss about the annual compliances of a Section 8 company. Whatever are the mandatory annual compliance which a Section 8 company is required to do every year, in this video we are going to discuss one by one all those provisions. As we know, Section 8 company do not aim for the profit. Their objective are purely for the charitable purpose, like for the promotion of the science, culture, research, sports. So Section 8 company does not have any profit intention and profit motto. As per Companies Act, there is no requirement of minimum paid up share capital for the Section 8 company. Whenever company we incorporate a Section 8 company, we require a license from the government for incorporation of Section 8 company. And Section 8 company is out of the definition of the small company. So Section 8 company can never be a small company. So let's discuss one by one the yearly compliances of the Section 8 company. Compliances are always divided into two parts. Some compliances which we have to report to the ROC and some compliances which we are not required to report to the ROC, but legally for the compliance of the company law we have to comply with such provision. So let's discuss one by one. First compliance under Companies Act is under Section 184 subsection 1, that is receipt of MBP 1. Every director of the company in first meeting of the board of director in each financial year shall disclose his interest in another entities. So it is mandatory for all the director to submit their interest in MBP 1 on or before first meeting of the financial year in form MBP 1. It is not required to submit or file this MBP 1 with the ROC, but company have to comply with the provision. Second requirement under Section 164 subsection 2 read with Section 143 section 3 clause G, DIR 8. Every director of the company in each financial year will file with the company disclosure of non-disqualification. Every director have to submit this disclosure with the company every year that he is not disqualified to continue as a director. Then company have to file some form with the ROC every year, like two form we all know, as an annual return and a financial statement. So first discuss the annual return. As per Section 92, every company is required to file e-form MGT-7 within 60 days of holding of annual general meeting of the company with ROC. As per Section 137, every company is required to file e-form AOC-4, that is as a financial statement of the company with ROC, within 30 days of filing of and within 30 days of holding of annual general meeting. So first compliance MBP1, second compliance DIR2, third filing of annual return, fourth filing of financial statement. Fifth, every company every year have to file e-form DPT3 within 90 days of closure of financial year, that is till 30th June. So as per Section 73, company have to file e-form DPT3 with ROC till 30th June every year. This is compliance number 5. Now the compliance number 6 is relating to the band 2, section 90. If there is any change in disclosure of significant beneficial owner, then companies are required to file e-form band 2 also with the ROC. 7th compliance DIR3 KYC. This we can say KYC of the director. So all the directors of the company every year have to comply with the KYC with the ROC. They have to file whether e-form DIR3 KYC or web form DIR3 KYC every year on or before 30th September with the ROC. Compliance number 8, MSME1. As per Section 405, every company within 30 days of every half year, within 30 days of end of every half year, required to file MSME1 form with the ROC. Compliance number 9, preparation of the director report. As per Section 134, every company is required to prepare the director report of the company every year. And the compliance number 10, that is financial statement and other relevant document. It is mandatory for every company to prepare the financial statement every year. Now the compliance number 11 and 12, that is relating to the board meeting and the general meeting. As per Section 173, Section 8 company is required to hold at least 4 board meeting in a financial year, and maximum gap between 2 board meeting can be 120 days. Same under Section 96, Every section head company is required to hold at least one annual general meeting in each financial year. Next, compliance maintenance of statutory registers. Section 8 companies also required to maintain some statutory registers like register of director, register of member, register of transfer, etc. Then appointment of auditor. As per section 139, every section 8 company is required to appoint an auditor for 5 financial year. So after 5 financial year, they again have to reappoint such auditor and appoint new auditor. So these are the some 12 or 13 compliances which a section 8 company have to comply every year, whether it is a working section 8 company or non-working section 8 company. Our complete write-up on the these compliances, our complete write-up on the annual compliance of section 8 company is already published on our blog. That is www.csdiveshgoyal.info. You can subscribe our channel and our blog for the regular update of the company law. Thank you so much.